his staff are going to do a great job. I think I'd like to throw out something that Daryl Royal told me earlier in the going. This decade belongs to the Bulls.
I like it.
Yes, sir. He also told me, Coach Royal was our legendary football coach. Many of you know him. So the first year, Tony, I'm out in the batting cage with some guys, and he comes out. He says, you that new baseball coach? I said, yes, sir. He said, well, how you going to be? I said, oh, we have really a strong potential, and I think we've got some great athletes. He just kind of looked down a little bit, then he looked right through me. And he says, you know, boy, that's what to get your ass fired around here. That potential doesn't get it. Coaches have to win the game. That's the bad news, because there's no other way to slice it. They have to win the game. But you can't. You cannot win the game. It's going to take all of you to win the game. All of you are going to have to get together, and all of the parents and all of the friends of the program are going to have to form a very strong team that brings the spirituality of what this place is to the field. That energy is more powerful than anything else, but it can't work unless it's authentic. It can't work unless there's that love for the team, and for the players, and the support that it takes. Mentioned about baseball being a game of failure, it's also a game of opportunity. Yes, it is. And that opportunity is there, because if you play the game and you play it right, you're going to learn something. The players are at this university, and you're supporting the players at this university to not only become great baseball players, more importantly, great citizens. The university represents a group of people working together to educate one person at a time for the betterment of society. That's what makes it work. Baseball is simply a metaphor for life itself, and the life skills can only be achieved and felt by the players if they make a best effort. And all of you need to support those best efforts. It's really easy to see the seven outs. But what about the productive outs? Do we get applause for that? The productive outs, batting averages really aren't the big issue. It's just one of four offensive skills. There's the batting average, hitting. There's bunting. Everybody that knows our program, we bunted 120 times the first year we went to the College World Series. Why? We couldn't hit. I mean, this isn't rocket science. No, even though NASA's in Houston, they never invited me down there. You know, think about baseball. It's nine is the final number. Nine, it's not even double digits. And then they keep it on a scoreboard. They don't think we're smart enough as coaches to be able to remember it's over after nine. Four bases, three outs. And you have to keep it simple. You really have to keep it simple for the players, for the fans, and everybody involved. But I want to tell the story, because there's someone very special here that can back the story up, and was a major part. He lives in Knoxville for a long time now. His name's Andy Pasillas. Where are you? Are you in the room? There he is, right back there. And his son is with him. I want to tell you a story that's going to apply to you. I want all of you to identify with this. In 1975, Cal State Fullerton was the athletic director called me in before the season started, and he said, "I got good news and bad news. What do you want to hear first?" I said, "What difference does it make? I'm going to hear them both. You pick." He says, "Well, the good news is we're going to raise your budget $1,500. I said, "Great. What's the bad news?" "We're going to Division I. Well, that made our budget $6,000 total for the year. Remember what I'm saying? Because at the end of this, you've all got to feel this about your team. We go ahead, we're picked last in the conference. We win. We're going to the regional championships. USC, y'all know them. They have won 5 national championships in a row prior to this year, and they have lost 6 games for the season. And we are going there to play them in our first ever regional championship in Division I, Cal State Fullerton, okay? So to give you an idea of where we rank in the minds of people, at the pre-party for the regional championships, a little gal comes up with a black cocktail dress on. She says, "You that coach from Fullerton?" I said, "Yes, ma'am." She says, "My name's Madeline. I play the organ at the ballpark at USC. We need a copy of your fight song." And I said, "Man, we ain't had much to fight about." And besides, we don't have a fight song. I said, "Besides that, if we had a fight song, we don't have a band. So what the heck's the use of having a fight song?" So that's kind of how it started. Now, the USC has that horse they run around, kind of like Florida State. This one goes around, it's a white horse. The guy does all kinds of weird stuff on it. Gets everybody fired up. So that's how they started, pregame. We go out on the field, and they play "It's a Small World." Right, Andy? "It's a Small World." We win. 3-1. John Manuel of Baseball America said recently that the 1975 win over USC by Cal State Fullerton was the biggest upset in the history of Division I sports. It was a miracle. But the real opportunities in baseball are endless. And that opportunity includes making the impossible happen. And it happened. We went to the College World Series. How that happened, I have no idea. We stayed with the fundamentals. We didn't even dress because we didn't have a bus at the ballpark. We dressed at home. The parents drove with the players and packed their lunches. All your parents out here have done all of that kind of stuff. So miracles and magic of baseball can only be brought to the surface. The opportunity is there for all of you, but you have to be together. It can't be, "Oh, we have this new coach and he's going to do this, he's going to do that." No, it's we're going to do this. Everyone in this room, Tony needs you, Frank needs you, all the coaches need you, the players need you. You've got to believe. So if I don't say anything else, let me tell you, it can happen. I don't know how we won in 75. It was God's gift to my coaching career. But what we had were players that were a team, parents that were a part of that team. Everybody, hey, they didn't like their role, but they didn't take away from the positive energy or the opportunities that were available and made magical by the game of baseball. Yeah, a lot of great things we're talking about. You know more about me than I do, John. Because we're only as good as our next game. But I really want to thank all of you for being here on behalf of the University of Tennessee. I remember those great games, those great football games on TV. I have followed this program a lot. I mean, we got orange. Texas has orange. They just burn it. tees on our hats, and we play baseball. So I just want to thank all of you for having me here, letting me be a part of this decade. It's going to belong to the Vols. Take care.
All right, how about one more round of applause for Augie Garrido.